Welcome to this Excel quickie. Here I'm going to show you how to quickly go to the very last cell in your worksheet, and maybe even more important, how to reset it once you delete the data from the last cell. So I have a list of data here, and the very easy way to get to the end of this list that I can see is Control Arrow Key Down. And if I want to go all the way to the right, Control Arrow Key Right, back up, Control Arrow Key Up. And Control Arrow Key Left. So that control with the arrow keys helps you navigate the data that you're currently in. But take a look at this guy. He is very small. That means there is some hidden data over here. Where is it? I don't know. My coworker must have put something over here to the right. Or more likely what happens is you are editing a spreadsheet and trimming down the size of it and you forget some data somewhere. So, how to go to the end of it? Very, very, very easy. Control End. And it takes you right there to the stray T1000. And if you want to get back to the beginning of your spreadsheet, Control Home. All the way to A1. Two very important keyboard shortcuts. Control End, Control Home. But we do have a little bit of a problem. So I want to remove data, right? And notice here this is in column BS and row 341. So let us remove the terminator, delete. Now I've cleaned my data, right? So let's go home. Let's go down here. Notice the bottom of my data right here is 330. But now let's go back to the end, Control End. It takes you to 341 and BS. So just like the T1000, it is rematerializing. And it's not taking us to the actual end of our data. And so Excel is basically thinking, hey, you did something with this cell before, so I'm just going to remember it as the end in case you want to come back, I guess. But the really easy way to get rid of this so that we just use our data set is in newer versions of Excel. You hit Control S, and now I can go home and then click End. And we go all the way down here to the end of our data, where there's actual data. So Control S is just saving the file. And that's great for new versions of Excel. So when you delete data from the end of your worksheet, just Control S to save it, and Control End is going to work again. However, in older versions of Excel, what you're going to have to do, this is really annoying, is select the last row or the first row underneath your last row of data. So this is an empty row, and I know there's nothing below it. And you might have to do Control Shift Down, select everything, right click, and go to delete that. And apparently, you might also have to go and do the same thing with the columns, where you select the columns, and then Control Shift to the right, right click, and delete. Now, this seems to be dependent upon the version of Excel that you have. I've got the new Excel 365, so all I have to do is to save the file, and then it resets it for me. And the last thing to point out is, so I'm telling you about Control End, but you also have an option for that on the Home tab in Find and Select under Go to Special. This is a great window. If you don't know about it, play around with it. But we have the Last Cell option right here. Now when I hit OK, it just does the same thing as Control End. It seems cool, but it's just Control End. So Control End paired with Control Home. And it's going to make your spreadsheet life that much better.